This is an extended talk I had with Jim Scott. Our little talk is about the hospitality industry and the importance of training to our Belizean people involved in this industry. We spoke about the work done in training by Jim and Lorena, his business partner. For the Belize Travelcast, I'm your host, Javier Gutierrez. All right, we're here once again with my very good friend, Jim. I am certain he loves to be around the desk of the Belize Telecast. And we're here today, we're going to be talking about the growth of the tourism and hospitality industries in Belize and the importance of training. You know, today, the industry is growing so fast that we will talk a lot about that importance. Jim, I'd like to welcome you once again to a program. And we have a very interesting episode to cover here today. Training, the importance of training. Belize is growing as a nation. The population is growing. There's a lot of changes taking place in our country every single day. The tourism sector as well is developing very fast, and the number of people coming in as well, they're beginning to pour in much more than before. How important is training to the industry, but even more than that, to the local people?
I think we could talk for hours on that subject.
Definitely.
I know this is a short podcast, but the demands of clients or visitors to Belize are changing. In a time period in our history where we're going from little mama papa, small resorts to the development of larger resorts, some all-inclusives, and then the name brands, the Hyatts, the Wyndhams, the Marriotts, the Four Seasons.
Yeah, we are San Pedro, I do understand, will be having two big Marriotts pretty soon.
That's correct. I think there's a Marriott Courtyard coming in, mm-hmm. and then there is a resort model called the Marriott Collection.
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah, right next to Banyan Bay and Grand Colony. And then Banyan Bay is turning into a Marriott as well, which all of that, I think, will be managed under the same group.
Yeah.
But you also have the Hyatt, Mahogany Bay, and you have the Wyndham up north that's coming in. And then Key Chapel, I think it's still happening, but it was said that they were going to be a Four Seasons. So that's kind of at the peak of brand standards out there in the world of hospitality.
And then Belize City has the Radisson.
And the Best Western.
The Best Western, and I think Ramada, right?
And Ramada, that's correct.
Totally correct. That's a princess.
The Princess Ramada. Yeah. Exactly.
Cool. That means that the development of the growth, the growth of tourism is increasing heavily in this nation.
Well, exactly. What brands really mean to us now is that if you are a branded hotel, that brand has their standards that in order to be a brand or that brand, you have to abide, follow through, execute, and train to maintain those standards. And in our business, we call SOPs, standard
Correct.
Operating procedures.
Yeah.
And that could be everything from the size of the mirror in the bathroom to the way we greet our customers and execute the services in hospitality.
So the angle of the remote control set in front of the television, as simple as that.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And what's on the bedside table, what's at the front desk, and what's, you know, done in every aspect of hospitality. Yeah. So those are the new standards that we never really had. There was just never anything documented. Mm-hmm. I'm sure some of the resorts did. But we didn't always refer to them as SOPs.
Yeah.
Now they're documented and numbered and stuff. So I think those are some of the really positive things that come with SOPs and brand standards. And of course, along with those SOPs or within the SOPs, there are also training standards.
Correct.
That you will have to train your staff every year or with new staff X, Y, and Z. Mm. Everything from safety and security, confidentiality to service
Correct.
Standards and execution.
Well, we're going to get into the details of training in just a little bit, but may I tell people and remind people internationally that Belize also is managed by our groups like the Belize Tourism Board. We have the Belize Tourism Industry Association. We have the Belize Hotel Association. We have the Tour Operators Association and different tour guide associations around Belize. And all of these organizations, Jim, are encouraging the different employees around the country in the different aspects of tourism to take training. Training is important, and now with the growth of tourism and the development of different trainings that exist, we realize how important it is. Now, I understand and I know that you do have an entity along with Lorena that is preparing Belize, not only locally, but you also bring in international standards, as you were talking about, into the training field in our beautiful nation. Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, you're speaking about Hospitality Training Services Belize.
Correct.
Which is a licensed entity through the American Hotel Lodging Educational Institute, AHLEI.
Correct.
Which is the educational wing to AHLEA. And it's been around, I think, since the 50s, but it's an educational institute that offers either online or self-taught or training curriculums in all aspects of hospitality.
Yeah.
And they have an excellent curriculum that is developed by international
connoisseurs.
Hoteliers,
yeah.
and academic, you know, there are University of Michigan, Cornell University, they're a big university in Houston, I forget the name of it. They have a great, these are all world-renowned kind of hospitality schools that contribute to the development. And the standards within the curriculum basically are very, very high standards.
Correct.
And I think the way we sell it too is that, you know, it doesn't matter if you're running a Four Seasons or if you're running a hostel. The principles that are taught there are transferable to any aspect of yeah. the hospitality industry. So we really like the curriculum. We're both very certified through AHLEI and have both worked as general managers and worked our way up through the industry. Lorena's young enough that she was able to enjoy higher education in local institutions, whereas right. when we were younger, yeah. they had no tourism programs.
Yeah. Well, I was lucky. I went to Barbados to do my certification in the CHDT area.
Oh, you did your CHDT
in Barbados.
Barbados.
Yeah.
Excellent.
I went to a very top tourism institution known as the Pomerine in Barbados, which that's where I certified through HLA as well as you were talking.
Okay,
yeah.
okay.
So yep. I understand what you're saying.
Yeah, yeah, it's a great certification.
And I believe in what you're doing. I mean,
and you had a good instructor.
Well, I mean, they're top of the line.
Yeah.
Like you said.
And Barbados has been in the hospitality industry for many,
longer,
many, many years.
Yeah, yeah.
So, and they have great educational mm-hmm. institutions. They also have per capita a very high standard of living.
Correct, correct. And that is why I captivated this conversation, because I believe in the drive that you and Lorena are putting into this nation. It is very important. I myself do training in this nation, but I don't do it the international standard the way you and Lorena are bringing it. And that's important for Belize. It is.
I think you do international standard. I think your experience as well as your certification and talents bring that to any training session you do. And I've always admired that about you. You're a good teacher and you have a lot of experience, hands-on experience to pull from.
Yeah.
Not just yours, but so many people
yeah,
that you've known.
Of course, of course.
I think that's what's really important when we are doing hospitality
Correct.
Or tourism training.
Correct.
I've always encouraged industry people to get involved in the education in their communities. Wherever your resort is or wherever your restaurant is, you have experience, something to offer younger Belizeans. Volunteer or go and teach at one of the high schools or vocational schools or universities.
And that's the reason I'm a fan of yours and Lorena, because you know what you're doing in that respect. You know what guiding is. You know what working in a hotel as a general manager is. So you understand the departments of the hotel. Likewise, Lorena, she has experience as well in working in hotel management. So when you develop your standards and you develop your knowledge and you certify through different houses, doing what you're doing, you will surely be more effective. And that's what I'm saying.
I hope so.
No, I'm sure, Jim.
Yeah, yeah.
So tell us, what's the response of the nation towards your training?
I think it's been very, very positive. I think between Lorena and I, we know a lot of people. So that's helped. You're not always a prophet in your own
country. Yeah.
But I think our reputation is kind of spreading. One of the biggest obstacles that we have, and we hear all the time from a lot of people in the industry, is that they didn't budget for that.
Yeah.
But you budgeted for nice, high thread count sheets and pillowcases. Why wouldn't you budget for training the people who are going to be taking care of your guests, the people who are going to be more responsible for the quality experience that our customers have when they come to Belize? Why wouldn't you? So those are the kind of questions that we're asking people. Secondly, sometimes there are trainers that come abroad, and I don't think it's different anywhere. I think having people from outside brings credibility.
Yeah, but you know what? We're beginning to kill that, Jim. We're beginning to change that in this country. Honestly, we are. Look at right now with the training of the tour guides in the professional corps. It's local people that are doing this. First, they used to bring in only foreign people to do this. Look at Lorena, look at yourself. Yeah. Right? Look at yourselves. I mean, you are local people that are developing hospitality training in this nation with international standards. And you told me that your institution is growing, you're successful. So we're beginning to bring in the local people.
I agree. Yeah. There's obstacles in anything you do, but it's how you cast the vision and sell the ideas.
Yeah.
And of course, it's always the results that you have.
Yeah.
And I think that's probably been our biggest selling point. You know, having dynamic educational programs that stick.
Yeah.
Where I think in our business, when that bell goes off in tourism professionals or a student's head, where, okay, I get it now.
Jim, I'm not tooting your horn here, man. I mean, look, we're talking training and your personality, what you have done for my development as your friend throughout my tourism career as a manager. You brought me from nowhere, Jim, and you gave me responsibilities that were bigger than I ever imagined from nowhere, and it helped me to become that person with much more responsibility and with the knowledge of the industry and the different departments in a hotel. Now, what you have taught me, you formalized into a trainer with a partner like Lorena, who has the experience in the industry as well. Brother, why in the world would I not believe in you as a trainer? I'm sure you're doing quite a fascinating job for Belize.
Thank you. My head is sweat.
No, but it's true. And like I said, I'm not tooting your horn.
Yeah, I think Javier, when people say that, I've been in the industry a long time. So sure, I've been in contact with a lot of people.
Yeah.
And I think culturally, growing up, I grew up in a culture where mentoring, encouraging younger people was a part of our DNA.
Yeah.
Is seeing people progress and being there for them and showing them the opportunities that are in front of them. True mentoring in its essence. I can't do the job for you.
No.
You have to show up on time.
Well, you're not a micromanager.
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah.
But you have to set your standard.
Correct.
But in response to what you said, thank you very much. But it was also your passion and your drive and what was instilled in you by your influences in life that created your success, that created the diversity of experiences you had. It was that experience. I was just somebody who said, okay, I'm in a leadership position. This is what I see for you, Javier. This is what you have to do. Yeah. I have to expect this. If we're going to be working together, this is what you have to do.
And this is what we need to do in Belize. This is what we need to change the attitudes of the locals towards training. They need to train. We cannot just be satisfied with the little bit that the hotel and teaches you. You have to go beyond.
And we have to realize what international standards
Thank
are.
You. Thank
what
you.
What international standard, what is expected, and how can we exceed that?
How do you do that?
Through mentoring, through organizations and businesses that say, this is what we're going to do, this is how we do it, and this is how we're going to reinforce that through training. So the consistency of the employee, that it's not just the passion, but being consistent at what you've learned, what you know, and delivering on a day-in, day-out basis, showing up on time, a basic standard.
Yeah.
You know, when you don't show up on time, if you are not properly groomed, if you are not properly attired, that has an effect on the experience. Those are just basic things, yeah. Let alone the technical skills on how to serve somebody, how to deliver a thematic walk on a natural history tour, those kind of things. If we don't have the basic standards of showing up on time, you're telling not only your customers, but your colleagues that you work with, you don't care.
You're not responsible enough.
You're not responsible. No, yeah. You're telling me if you don't show up, that means I have to do your job.
Yeah.
And those are just basic things. So once we have that foundation, and then we have the passion for what we do, and then we assert ourselves in gaining knowledge and getting better at what we do, whether it's learning about wines or the wine you're selling.
How much people have you trained? Certified.
Through HDS, I think Lorena has trained a lot more and certified a lot more than myself. But I think this year, 200, 300, 400,
wow.
Something like that.
Wow.
Yeah.
That means that these people are responding to your standards.
Yeah. Was it last year or early this year? We certified 12 Belizean general managers.
Yeah.
As CHA.
Correct.
So I think I may have been the only CHA-certified individual in the country. We now have 12,
yeah.
13. And then everything from guest services gold, which I think is the foundation, from general managers to bellman should take that course.
Correct.
It's foundational on
Correct.
The same standards that we're talking about,
yeah.
And what the responsibility of a hospitality professional is.
Give us a little bit of the different trainings you do.
Well, guest services gold,
mm-hmm.
Housekeeping,
yeah.
Front desk manager, food and beverage, restaurant server.
You do maintenance,
food
too,
and
right?
beverage, food and beverage executive, maintenance.
Yeah.
Being in the hotel business a long time, I've learned a lot of things about maintenance.
Well, of course.
But I'm not a qualified electrician. I'm not a qualified plumber. I understand standards within those disciplines.
Mm-hmm. But as a trainer, you don't have to know the details, but you can
Lorena has
training.
Been pushing me to get certified
yeah.
in maintenance so I can teach
yeah.
maintenance, hotel. But remember, when you're teaching maintenance, like any other area in hospitality, there's foundational standards
Correct.
That you teach along
Correct.
With that. So, you know, putting in a receptacle outlet, that's only part
that's
of the equation.
That's basic. Yeah.
Yeah. But how you leave your work area, because a customer is either going to see
yeah.
that you were there working, or a housekeeper is going to have to come in.
That's attitudinal, no.
Exactly.
Those
are the kind of things that we need. You're yeah. walking through a hallway or through a public area and greeting a customer. And it doesn't matter that you're carrying a screwdriver or carrying a tray. We all have that responsibility to make our customers feel safe and feel welcome.
Happy, yeah.
And we have that opportunity to give them a real positive experience about Belize.
Yeah.
And all of that is a part of that training.
How do you see the local population in the hospitality industry now? Do you see a different picture today versus 5 years ago?
Absolutely, because now we do have a more institutional educational forms. We're talking about the same subject, and we have secondary schools that have tourism programs. Yeah. We have tertiary schools that have these programs, and we also have vocational. Unfortunately, the difference between a tourism program and hospitality program are very different.
Yeah.
So I think we're evolving now using the right language and the right focus within curriculums, because we've been having these conversations with some of these educational institutions that, you know, coming out of school with a tourism degree, it's pretty general. It's a liberal arts.
Yeah. I always tell people that there was one guy that came to me once a few years ago when we were at the Radisson. Uh-huh. And he said to me, man, I went to apply at the Radisson for a front desk job, and they told me I have to be just an ordinary receptionist. And I said, what do you mean? He says, man, I just graduated from the University of Belize with my tourism degree. And I said, young man, do you know I don't have that degree, but you would never get my job over me? I said, and I can prove that to you. I said, because I have much more knowledge than you do because of the years. I don't have the degree, but I have the experience. You have to grow into it. And this is what a lot of people have to learn, Jim. That it's not about just going to school. It's about literally gaining the experience, having the love, and accepting that it's a total different lifestyle.
Well, it's having the foundation, as you say. And I've had that experience many times with interviewing university degree, sixth form degree, young people. And there is something culturally in Belize, which is very different than the way I grew up. I grew up in an area where we kind of had to work.
Yeah,
if you wanted to do certain things, you were encouraged to work, make your own money. And if you wanted to work in a certain field, you probably were going to try to work around that.
Yeah.
And there are so many jobs in hospitality where you could work part-time. And going back to the experience or the story that you explained, how could somebody with a university degree and no human resource management leadership roles walk into a situation like a hotel or a restaurant
can't do it.
And manage people who have been doing it for 10 years, 12 years, 20 years.
Nope.
You know, it's very, very difficult. It'd be very challenging. They would have to be a special person with incredible skills in order to be able to be successful.
It's almost highly impossible.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
And that includes both having the fiscal, financial knowledge of that position, scheduling people, managing controls, safety, human resource skills, and technical skills, understanding a PMS, you know, a property management system, a POS, point of sales, managing inventories, all of that kind of stuff. How is, and unless you've had that experience foundationally, you know, working at the front desk or working in a restaurant as a waiter, as a bartender, you know, as a supervisor, it'd be really difficult. Yeah. You know, the degree is great. That's awesome. That means you have an aptitude and you have a passion for learning. Great.
Correct.
But managing people.
It's a different thing.
It's a different thing.
Let's take a short break, Jim, and then we're going to get back with the conversation for another 5 minutes, and then we're going to close off. Okay?
Okay.
All right. When we come back, I will ask you what your next step in a training. All right, we're back once again with the Belize Travelcast. A good friend of mine, Jim Scott, once again here with us. And let's go dive right into it, Jim. Tell me, what's the next step for training in Belize?
Training more trainers.
Hospitality training.
Yeah, training more trainers.
That's a good
getting
goal.
More people out there doing what we do.
That's a good goal.
Yeah.
Yeah. You need to train trainers to get more training done.
Exactly. And more properties, more businesses need internal trainers in order to train.
You ever thought about getting into the Go Green initiative as in training too? Training that aspect of the industry?
I like the idea of it, but
the database is huge.
Yeah, but the I think putting best practices in an institution. Yeah, I like the idea of it, but with the volume of work that we currently have in areas of service and, mm-hmm. and hospitality, some of those technical skills, and it's a little overwhelming sometimes, you know. And I think there's enough work out there for people to specialize in that area. But as a value system, yeah, I'm totally 100% behind it. And I don't think I would ever be a part of another private business unless those types of principles.
Well, you transformed the institution called the Radisson, and that was one of the most difficult to do.
You know, last year the Radisson was given the award as the greenest hotel in all the Radissons worldwide.
You know what makes me laugh too? I was there when that program began. Remember that, right?
Yeah.
I believe in it so much too. And then when we introduced it to the staff, the managers were like, "Oh no, people just bring more work to it. You're just bringing more work to us. That's craziness, you know, to be weighing garbage and all this type of thing." No!
Yeah.
No! You cannot talk to these people about negatively against this thing.
Yeah, they're experts now.
Wow, they are.
And that it's a good thing.
Of course.
And, you know, whenever you laden somebody with extra work or changes, you know, there's sometimes a fight. But I think a natural process of evolution and developing values and best practices. And
but let's stick to your point a little bit. Let's stick to your training a little bit. Why my mind is blank.
Okay.
Give me the certification.
AHLEI.
AHLEI. That's what I'm trying to tell
you. The American Hotel Lodging Educational
Institute. That's right. I think my mind went blank because Lorena is watching us there. But tell us a little bit more, Jim. Let Belize understand. Let the world understand the preparation that you're beginning to give people under this certification.
Well, it's international certification. The American Hotel Lodging Educational Institute has been around for a long, long time. And they have very specific curriculums for all areas of hospitality and education.
Correct.
They now have educational certification to be a hospitality educator.
Yeah.
So those certifications are for people who are in vocational schools and secondary schools, tertiary schools that are teaching hospitality subjects.
Yeah.
And they're recognized globally. So they're not getting a certificate that Jim Scott has signed or Javier Gutierrez has signed or BTB or BTIA has signed. They're getting a certificate from an internationally recognized institution.
Yeah.
That has very, very high hospitality standards.
Maybe what you should do too, Jim, is do a little promotion to the different institutions like the IT vets around the country. And you get your trainer to go and train their trainers so that their certification can be accepted internationally.
Well, it's funny you said that. We did earlier this year, Lorena and I both did a presentation to the Ministry of Education after a conversation I had with our minister, Patrick Fabro, and he invited us to meet with all of his district education officers.
Correct.
And CEO, and that includes secondary, tertiary, and vocational schools.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So we did present to them and we told them what we were doing.
Yeah.
You know, and, you know, the only ones who followed up were the vocational wing.
And you know what? I admire that.
Yeah.
Because I do believe in SET. I go up to SET quite frequently to do my tour guide certifications, and I think they're very proactive.
Well, I was going to say, you know, a lot of functions that I go to, I see that students and supervisors, teachers from the school
Correct.
Are actively involved
Correct.
In not just sitting in an institution and teaching, but they're out there practicing and serving the public and businesses in hospitality services, especially food and beverage, catering and stuff like that. But there are other areas in CAIO. So from what I see, and I'm not here all the time, the CAIO set is really, really active.
Very active.
But that's a leadership thing.
Yeah,
and CAIO is always I don't think Kayo has had a leadership void. There's always people who are passionate and want to get out there and do productive things mm-hmm. and give experiences to other people. And
all right, so we want the world to know that Belize is definitely growing and preparing its people for the hospitality industry. As I mentioned before, my buddy Jim, his girlfriend, they have this institution that trains people and prepares them internationally with international certification. And we continue to encourage that so that you people from abroad know when you come into this nation, you have people that are qualified and very conscious of your happiness in our nation as you visit.
Thank you, Javi. Yeah, Hospitality Training Services is alive and very active. And part of HTS Belize is also the 501 Hub.
Correct.
So if you want a unique dining experience.
I've eaten there.
In Belize City.
Yeah.
Come to the 501 Hub.
All right. There you go. That's a free commercial I'm giving you there, okay? Nonetheless, people, Jim, any last words? Well, not last words, but on this program.
Yeah. You're coming to Belize. Enjoy everything that Belize has to offer. You're just coming here to sit on the beach. Embrace your bartender. Embrace your waiter. Embrace your tour guide. Embrace the security officer. You'll probably find a very unique individual there, a special person, just like all over Belize. And yeah. And I think that's part of the experience when you come here, not just the palm trees and
correct.
Beautiful jungle and rivers and caves and archaeological sites, but it's the people.
All right. And there we have it, people. We had a very interesting conversation with my buddy Jim. That has his institution with his girlfriend, and they're developing Belize with international standards in the tourism industry, and that's a beautiful thing. Remember, Belize is lovely. We have the breeze, the wind, we have the trees, we have the oceans, we have the mountains, we have the rivers, we have everything. But the most beautiful contribution that this nation has when you visit, it is people. Its people is the most beautiful resource. And what we're doing is we're training our Belizean people to learn how to keep you happy when you visit this nation. And you will be happy, I am sure, because training is surely an integral part of the growth of our nation. For the Belize Telecast, Javier Gutierrez. See you next time.
Travelcast.
What did I say?
Telecast.
I said telecast. Travelcast, man.